to our next session of proximity sensors. This is what we were looking at in the previous session. We went through few types of proximity sensors: capacitive, inductive, and magnetic. I am a course instructor, Mohan Padia, in measurement and industries. We are learning with proximity sensors. Our next type is photoelectric proximity sensors. When we say photoelectric, means one or other type of light rays come into the action. Here you see in the graphics animation, one source is emitting light, reflectors are there, and as and when the wave goes down and wave goes up, that reflects back and it counts the oscillations of the wave. So here basic operation is based on the light emitted and reflected back. Depending on the change in the amount of light from object to the detector, that will count or that will check the presence of the object. It may be a visible light, it may be invisible light, like in case of IR infrared sensors, and laser sensors are there. So there are two, three types of sensor, basic types. The one is retro reflective sensor. Basically, it is reflective sensor. When we say reflection, it means from the object, the rays go back to the sensor. Here, the emitter of the light and detector both are in the same housing. So here, first we see retro reflective sensor, where from sensor light is thrown, then it goes to the reflector here, and as an object comes into the path, the amount of light is changed, which is received by the sensor. Here I am giving you a little bit more detail, that emitting a beam of light that is striking the object is coming, and some physical housing structure is required. Like, so within the one structure, emitter and detector both are present. Here emitter is light emitting source and detector is light detecting source. Another is diffuse reflective sensor. So the difference is here, when light is emitted from the source, it goes into the atmosphere, doesn't come back. But as and when object comes in between, now you see the diagram here, from the object the part of light is reflected back. So this is diffuse reflective sensor. Let us see a few examples of this. A ball is coming, otherwise the light is going into the atmosphere, and when ball comes into the detection area, it is identified by the sensor. And if we add a multiple array, we can detect the large area or object fast moving through the large area can be detected. One of the application is the sports analytics, where movement of the ball, like say in the tennis court or in the cricket ground, it can be detected very easily and the speed can be measured. Here, two diffuse reflective sensors are combined in this third diagram, where at the two different axes they are shown. So face, the face is either it is horizontal, see this is horizontal, or say vertical, both will be detected. These are the best example of diffuse reflective sensor. The third one is through beam sensor. Again, fundamental remains same. The one is emitter, another is receiver. So two separate housing are required. Basically, it is used for drowning of the object passing through the continuous processing line, where emitter passing the light to the receiver. And in this case, as and when again object comes in between, that line is broken by the presence of the object, the line through which light passes through. So here you see the example, here what we are looking at. The object is passing through the bell, and every time the light ray is being cut by the presence of the object. Similarly here, see, object box is passed and signal is given. Every time box passes, it is cutting the line of the light. So two separate units are required here, and separate receiver or detector is also required. When object breaks the light beam, the detector register this break, like as a counter you can work, or how much is nearby you can detect, etc. So the application of this triangle, that is one of the IR sensor, is very, you know, popular in your project nowadays. Very small unit is coming with the one emitter, and the black or dark LED is as an IR receiver. So as when an object is detected, the light reflected back to the IR receiver, and they can be very easily configured with the audio board, where this is the ground and output connections are to be made on the certain digital pins. Okay, so it detects the presence of the object. But the limitation is, it works on a very small range. Okay. So let us see the advantage of IR sensors, contactless detection, and the very useful application is it can work in daytime and night time also. Communication is very secure, and it is able to measure the distance of the soft object. Please keep in mind, soft object means the objects which are absorbing the rays. Let's say if sound rays are there, so they will be absorbed by the object. So here being infrared light, it will be reflected back very easily from the soft object and will be detected. And like say if object is having corrosion or oxidation, the results will not be affected. Disadvantages are there, like it cannot detect through the walls or doors. Then we saw in the previous session that magnetic sensors are useful for such application where you need to detect through walls and doors, because if it is light rays, they cannot pass through the thick wall or doors. And always it is required line of sight action. So certain linear movement is always required for the light rays. And as I said, it was in a very limited distance, within few millimeters. Let us go with the next, ultrasonic proximity sensors. Again, very easily available in the market for your projects, where directly you can configure it with the Arduino Nano or Unoverse. And the one of the best applications we have seen is the parking assistance system in the automatic vehicles or automobiles, which we see. Even it is used in the water filling plants. It actually works like IR, but it is not part of photoelectric proximity sensors. Okay, here because it doesn't emit the light rays, it emits the sonic waves, sound waves, which are beyond the capacity or beyond the range of the human ear that can detect. And it counts the time taken to send the rays and coming back, and it will be calculated on the basis of the time taken by the sound waves coming back. So again, advantage is contactless, and the best part is not affected by the object colors and transparency. You see, IR sensor, in case we saw previously that light rays are absorbed by certain colors. Even in case of transparent object, IR would not be useful. So here the solution is ultrasonic sensors. Even it is less affected by the external environmental condition, and even in dark environment it can work, low current consumption, and compared to inductive capacity and IR sensor, it has much higher. It has much higher range, like say up to, it can measure up to 1 meter distance. Disadvantages are also there. It cannot work in the vacuum. It cannot work in the vacuum since they are sound waves. So always we know sound waves always required a medium to flow. And again, soft objects, like say, it may be a cloth, it may be curtain, it may be a sponge material. So it may be possible that sound waves will be absorbed by such kind of soft object and with the extreme texture. So that will not be useful then. Going ahead, we went through different sensors, proximity sensors. The one is inductive sensors, optical, that is photoelectric. Another is magnetic sensor, where we saw like the leak type and volume type. Capacitive sensors, ultrasonic sensors. So this is the entire comparison that you can remember, where let us recall that inductive sensors are useful only for the metallic. Optical sensors can be used with all type of material. In case of magnetic sensors, we must have presence of magnetic field. Again, capacitive sensors can work with the almost all kind of material. Ultrasonic can work with the almost all kind of material, except few soft materials. Now, if you look at the operating range, so inductive has 50 mm or below, and capacitive are also 50 mm or below. Magnetic transducers, like being the limitation to the actual spread of the magnetic field, it can work up to 80 millimeters, and again optical transducers up to 100 millimeters, and ultrasonics they can use up to 50 meters. And again, if you look at the parameter like robust and vibration, robustness and vibration environment, so their sustainability is quite high in all cases. And looking at the cost, like you know, cost doesn't make any difference when you talk about the accuracy. So it is almost comparatively market prices there, and sensitivity. So inductive sensors are sensitive to surrounding material. Optical sensors, like optical sensors, we talk about photoelectric sensors. So they are affected by the dust and oil and the shapes of the object. If you talk about the volume type and range type, so external another magnetic field will disturb. So they are sensitive to external electromagnetic fields, which are, you can say, stray magnetic fields. Capacitive sensors are affected by the humidity and vapors. And ultrasonic sensors are affected by the airflow and temperature variation, because in ultrasonic we talk about the sound waves. So this is one approximate comparison among all types of sensors that we have seen. And here we finished with the topic proximity sensors here. We did it in two parts, please go through it. And in the description, some 7-8 questions are given. Please solve them. It will be useful to memorize the entire session. Thank you so much. We will meet in the next session.